Hey guys, Stobbie, I'm back again with some more XCOM 2, and it's the Avenger Defense. Yes! Been waiting for this for quite a while, to have a late game Avenger Defense. Super powerful troops. And look at our beautiful, beautiful turrets. I can't wait to take our first shot with them. Check this out, there's even a pod, or one alien from a pod, right in view. Heavy turret, you wanna start us off? Man, that's so cool having our own turrets. Go on, buddy. Kill! Nice! Yeah, you bend over that rock. And he can still go into Overwatch, that's amazing. That's an unexpected bonus.
Alright!
That's probably gonna reveal, but that's fine.
Here we go!
Hello, snakes! We're on Overwatch, what kind of percentage? They would shoot normally at 80%. 56. But of course, that snake I would expect to have a higher dodge value. And of course, the turrets will have the Overwatch reaction penalty. So then they won't be as accurate. But fair enough. Go ahead and clear out this cover here. We want to deforest almost this entire area anyway, so that's not a problem. Not too far on the left flank, because we're going to need that to advance through. Alrighty. Vandermeer.
Kein Problem.
Nice. 88. 73. Look at the defense. 25%. Wow. Do we have anyone who can use auto targeting? No. We do not. Probably surprising though. I'll move Morozova instead because she can take two shots from here at that snake. Great work. I'd like to move her up if possible. You know what? Probably kill that snake. The boa. Boas are very dangerous. Vandermeer, can you take down the trooper? Ho! 17 damage critical, you surely can. So we've got Thompson, we've got Dahl, we've got Kingsley.
Let's do this!
Just gonna move everybody up forward here. E3 is rubbish. Oh, look at that, he's got rapid fire. That's amazing. Run and gun rapid fire, of course, the single best combo of skills in the game.
Let's move already.
Serpent suit panic, interesting. Didn't expect that to happen. I forgot that would happen, of course. I'm a jackass. Well, I suppose that means that Morozova can just move into cover then and not worry about the snake, because it'll just take fire damage on this turn and more fire damage in the next turn.
On your order.
So really, the team can just keep advancing forward and to the left while overwatching. We are, of course, going to have the advantage of these turrets protecting us as we move up. On these Avenger Defense missions, of course, you have loads of enemies just running at you. Just like that. Miss, 70% miss, that's very unlucky.
I've got eyes on advent troops.
Now that mech isn't gonna move forward, so I'm gonna wish I had that sniper. Oh, armor, wow, that's a lot of armor. Great hit, Thompson.
X-ray neutralized.
So cool having these turrets. Whoa, more of them. Baddies, more baddies. Oh, that's asking for a grenade. Run into Overwatch, you fool! Hit two. Oh, that Guardian proc.
Hostile target down.
Oh yes, you know you're getting grenaded. Another pod, holy crap. And I knew we were in for a rough ride, but...
Reinforcements in from the Avengers reserves.
Now, if I know how the game works, then this would have been Jack who's going to come through. Oh, it's green, I mean, yeah. I picked a random soldier, that's unlucky for us. Okay.
On your order.
Half cover is fine, someone else is going to take that high cover. Green, who can you see? You can see quite a lot. Can't flare anyone. can take an 87% shot at that mech. Heavy anti-riot mech. I don't know what it has in terms of abilities, and honestly, I don't want to find out. What can these turrets do for us? Nothing, just overwatch. Hell, we can even pull everybody back and just make all of these aliens run into overwatch fire. Why not? I mean, look, can we be seen from that position back there? Yeah, why not? Let's do that.
Yeah.
I mean, if the turrets get damaged, who cares?
We're waiting.
Not a problem. Right, everybody get back.
Finally.
Alright, keep your head down. Only half cover, of course.
Digging in.
So we want our best overwatchers to be right on the front lines, which would be Thompson here. Hell, he can even use Killzone, but he only gets one shot at it. Can't move. And do that, fair enough.
Overwatch.
Incham. The main thing is to get Morozova back onto this position here in high cover. Normally I like to be hyper aggressive, but I feel that's not appropriate here. Given that we have these turrets and what they can do for us. What we do need to do is launch a rocket though, and Vandermeer I think is going to do just that. We can stay in half cover, because she's got 23 hit points, look at that, and 2 armor. Amazing. If she can blow up that guy's cover and shred some of the mech's armor just like that, we'll leave that tree intact in front of us. No way of, okay, we don't seem to be able to.
Fire,
I thought I would have given her one of the special rockets, but hey. Seems to have done just enough. But Dahl only has 12 hit points. Don't want him up front.
I
think from back here, he should be far enough back, he's not in too much danger. Oh, he's got the extra long sight from the weapon he's using. Should we use domination? I mean, why not? 100%, 100% prime battle commander. Yes, please. The 4 or 5 turn cooldown on domination, I think. Okay, Tarek, what can you see? You can take one shot, probably miss 25%. 4 hits, nicely done. Going to overwatch. Comp turret, overwatch, heavy turret. Can we shred its armor in any way? No. Do I think that Wardog and the turret can fit? Oh, the turret can fish it off almost itself with 2 shots. I mean, it has to hit both, but I'm gonna prefer to put Green into overwatch because she's got the improved overwatch ability. Okay. Devil Dog, overwatch. I do hope we get a sniper. And there's another pod, holy crap. Oh no, sorry, that's the first pod we saw earlier. We couldn't see us. We could see them because of the extra vision from one of the rifles. Thompson, you legend. Oh, turrets. What is... Whoa, that's a scary gatekeeper. I don't think it's seen us yet. Oh, it has. It's seen our mind-controlled unit. That is always the risk you take. Mind-controlling someone. Now, that tech trooper is a real problem because it might have the passive discharge ability. I'm glad that most we don't want that thing splitting. Is that a one-shot? It's not, so it's going to split. Oh, one damage point too little. Very unfortunate. What is he gonna do? Oh, missed. Okay, so let's use our Advent Prime Battle Commander for as much trouble as we can. I can't throw a frag grenade because I'm burning. I think we'll just use him to clean up this. Really, who can I shoot the bit? 90, 60, 60, 60. So it's really just gotta be the 90. Thank you, Battle Commander, you're too kind. And at this point I do need to move War Dog back though.
I'm on it.
We've got to remain respectful of that Guardian. The thing is, I don't think anyone can see it. One of the turrets might be able to, but that's not too much of a problem, frankly. It's still going to move towards us on the next turn. Now, whenever I have these turrets unable to see anybody, I'm just going to put them straight into Overwatch. I think we need an explosive here just to clear out some more of their cover. Blast a bomb. Right there. When we advance through this cover here. Also, I want to detonate that car so that it can be safe to approach later on. The danger of hiding behind an unexploded car is that if it takes fire, it can explode and damage your trooper. Oh yeah, 60%. What? It didn't remove the cover. Still a good hit though. Man, these turrets are doing the business. It's essentially like having four infantrymen who can't move. Incredibly powerful, I love it. Thompson. Now, more's over. I want you right on front. But not in vision. Perfect. Now, I'm actually going to have her overwatch. And I don't have high cover here, unfortunately. I don't think it's necessary.
Oh, okay, I'll wait.
Devil dog. I want her to get the extra shot. I'm sure we can achieve that by having Vandermeer in half cover and aid protocol. Extra defense. Although she doesn't need it, she's got 23 points. Totally fine. This should hit. Certainly does. Just gotta hope that Guardian doesn't take too much damage to us. Who needs a heal? Oh, the Advent Prime Battle Commander. Should I give him 8 protocols to keep him alive longer? And give him an Overwatch shot? Why not? LOL. Advent Prime Battle Commander. MVP. Actually move to high cover. Our troops are a little bit grouped up here, so we're quite exposed to a Psionic Rift. I don't think Guardians can use Psy Rift. Pretty sure it's only Elders who can do it. Domo, keep creeping forward.
Let's move already. Overwatch.
Yes, run into Overwatch, you fools! The shotgun, it's obviously gonna miss. That's unlucky that that missed. That doesn't miss. And that doesn't miss. 15 damage and it's not even a crit. You're gonna raise zombies, that's totally fine. Zombies are mostly harmless and we can remove them with our turrets. This trooper, okay, she's gonna drop a shield, that's fine.
Sending reinforcements in from the Avengers reserves.
Thank you, Bradford. Still burning. They still can't use his grenade. I want to use the grenade. How come the Overwatch didn't trigger? Interesting. Obviously it doesn't work with allied units. Enemy units rather. So fire for effect. No, not worth it. How do we maximize here? More explosives? Or do we just... Awesome, there's the sniper we wanted. But it's Olsen, unfortunately. Not ideal. Anyway, let's put it there for the next turn. The sniper I wanted is Ito. Can you see heavy turret? Yeah, the zombies are effectively harmless, and it's so cool that you don't have to actually, you don't even have to reload. Yeah, Marzova, just keep reloading and overwatching. I mean, these zombies are going to have to move towards us, and they're going to eat a lot of overwatch when they do so. No need for us to press forward just yet. Chem. Might as well take it down. I wonder if the Guardian can just keep reanimating them. I hope not. Be a little bit BS. Oh, reload first.
I'm ready. On Overwatch.
Just conscious that time is ticking away a little bit. We want to get busy here. Wasting his Overwatch. We want to get damage onto the shield bearer. Shoot at the disruptor. Nah, do some damage to this tech commando. Although it's probably just gonna be absorbed by shield. This is pretty cool that you don't have to reload the turrets. That OP? A little bit. Domo, you fine where you are? No need to push forward just yet. At the right time, he'll charge forward and double shot. Probably the Guardian. Yes, the Guardian's going to eat all the Overwatch. It's actually not ideal. No damage because of all the shield and the armor. Only one damage got through. Wow. Hardly any damage getting through. Look at that. Only suffered 6 damage through all that. And some horrible psychic ability is going to be used. Okay, just one shot's a turret. That's not the end of the world. Haha! Our amazing battle commander dodges. We might actually lose her on the next turn. But if she's able to kill anyone or anything, I want it to be that tech commander who's shielding everybody. Yeah, Chris. Wrecked. Motion in for green there. Oh, it's a zombie! Haha, missed! Please tell me we get the trooper, we get him for one more turn, that'll be so cool. Okay, and he's no longer burning as well, awesome. He could grenade then. How much does a grenade do? 3-6, no. We'll take the shot rather. Might even aggro this pod here, which wouldn't be the end of the world. Kill that tech commando. Nice! Alrighty, Morozova. Clear that Guardian, which Chris will need, so that he can double shoot it to shred its huge armor.
Yes.
Puts him in half cover, but that's fine. Chain shot. Oh yeah, full shredded. Nice armor, bro. Now we might, well, we could have been able to put the sniper in a position where she could actually shoot the objective. Like right there. But not necessary on this turn.
Good to go.
Olsen will use her sniper rifle to shoot the objective as we move up on it. Or is over, do the honors here. Rosava, a colonel, yes she is, so she's rather gonna reload and overwatch. We've established that there's no real need to save and load to get her back into position. It's still showing her as in high cover from that direction. But not the end of the world. Vandermeer's a colonel already, Thompson's a colonel. Gold doesn't get XP from kills. Need to do turrets. Green could do with another level up. Domo is a colonel. Vandermeer is a colonel. Yeah, so it's got to be green then that gets the kill.
Heading out.
Yeah, 71. That's rubbish. Oh, no, I believe in you. surprised Green's not a colonel, because I mean, she was in the very first mission we had. I suppose that really is the effect of the fatigue mod in action. Fatigue mod does have the consequence of really gimping your XP growth. Now in Season 2, when we use the All Pods Active mod, I don't think fatigue is going to be a good idea. We're also going to be using with the larger pod sizes mod for starting with 6 cap to 8. I think that having fatigue is going to put too much stress on our barracks. Fatigue was kind of arbitrary, I always felt. I mean, like, a soldier goes out, they really need 9 days off? I mean, no. AI is just confused. Nice.
I'm sending reinforcements in from the Avengers reserves.
Looks like they called in some friends.
Oh.
Commander, the situation just got worse.
Really? We still have this battle commander?
Reporting enemy transports on the move across this region. They're getting ready for an all-out assault.
So, I want to aggro that pod to bring it towards us. I also want to take some shots on the objective. Hell, Olsen can probably finish it off now. Well, the next turn. We might have to run our scout for the next turn. God, that was easy.
Target destroyed. Excellent work, Menace 1-5. Shen, what's our status?
Whatever it was, destroying it seems to have lifted the disruption field.
Got a letdown. God, that was easy.
We should be clear to take off within 60 seconds.
I feel like even without the turrets, we would have been just fine. When you really need these turrets is in the super early game, and that's when you're not able to get them, so...
Tired of waiting around.
I do want to kill this battle commander, though. The Psy Zombie, I'm not worried about it. Can't reach us anyway, so no point in taking it down.
On the move.
Yeah, that battle commander will just have to walk forward and eat Overwatch like everybody else.
Got it covered.
Over. Overwatch. Reload Overwatch. God, these guys dropping into into as reinforcements are gonna have a bad time. We got Sharma.
Let's do this.
Fair enough. Should we stay and kill everything?
Covering now.
Maybe we shouldn't. That might be a little bit cheeky of us, considering that we're going to be facing reinforcements the whole time.
Overwatch.
Let's watch this reinforcement group get annihilated, though. Oh, unlucky, bro. Good hit. Terrible miss. And skewered. Yep, the mech does go straight into Overwatch. How long is this mind control working? This mind control is going to have to wear off at some point.
Menace 1-5, be advised, we've picked up hostile reinforcements inbound on your position.
Let's shred this mech's armor. Green, just keep farming the XP, I suppose. Weaken that mech a little bit. What would the heck be? 100% shutdown, 86 control. Wow, that's actually damn big. Yeah. Vandermeer, give us a little pistol shot there. Good lord. Means Green can finish it off. And we can retreat my next turn.
Terminated.
That battle commander is going to come to his senses at some point and get overwatched harder than anyone's ever been overwatched before.
Moving to Overwatch.
On Overwatch.
Got it covered.
That's a lot of Overwatch. I thought you should be able to see it. Yeah. Let's just grab a flank and a shot. See, it didn't show the icon there, so. Doesn't show a flanking icon either because it's showing him as a ally. E3 defense, weapon range, fair enough. Take the shot, probably gonna miss. Doesn't though.
Whoop! You see that?
Sure did. Yes, run towards us, friends.
Advent troop spotted.
No, they're not even in vision. We can just run everybody back into the Avenger.
They've got friends.
If I wanted to be cheesy and waste your guys' time, I would stay here and just farm reinforcements as they drop. But let's not do that. Let's GDFO and put a cap on the easiest Avenger defense mission ever.
All right. Copy that.
No. Fine, right there. Green, who else is out? Just the turrets. Oh, no, hang on, we got a little trooper there we almost left behind. Bummo.
Running!
That's everyone. Bam! Avenger mission in the bag.
Excellent work, Commander. Looks like the Avenger lives to fight another day.
That was like six turns. Oh, eight turns. Easy. Okay, as usual, I'm going to cut off this loading screen because it's taking forever these days. Well, there we go. That puts a cap on an incredibly easy Avenger defense mission. Well done, team. Everyone performed spectacularly. Codex Brain is all we recovered. Doesn't matter. Oops, someone in green. Motion. Green. Bobby's two. There you are. Established defenses. Oh yeah. Alrighty, so Commander, still have a supply drop. Here's. I wonder if going headquarters will be worth it because we have so many supplies. Maybe we can just buy spare scientists. Speed up this last little bit of research.
Welcome, Commander.
An engineer and a grenadier. Rapid construction and medical needed. We need any more intel? I think so.
Facility coordinates locked in, Commander.
That's fine. Okay. Don't need it. Just need the last few missions now.
Just like the one we found the Commander in.
On the surface, yes. But in function. Ah, Commander, excellent. We can begin. It is no secret that Advent soldiers possess both human and alien genetic characteristics. Preliminary analysis led me to believe that this was the result of direct modifications made to a pre-existing human host, prisoners, or perhaps even unwitting volunteers.
See your local Advent recruiter today.
However, the reality is something else entirely. The Advent troopers at the facility we discovered, including the specimen before you, were manufactured. Each soldier possesses a unique genetic code. Predominantly human, of course, but with some fragments left open.
Left open for what?
Whatever alien DNA Advent wishes to insert. Sectoid. Mutine.
Whoa.
Even the species our soldiers refer to as berserker. In all cases, human genetic material serves as a bonding agent, holding the strands together.
Human material? You mean the stuff we found at the Blacksite facility?
Precisely. The key component in their soldier manufacturing process.
So we've been fighting ourselves this entire time.
In a way. But I believe there's more to it than that. The human DNA in this specimen bears one key difference from the entirety of the sequences decoded in the Shadow Chamber. Psionic sensitivity. Given the sheer volume of strands involved, this cannot be accidental.
Screening process at the clinics. Avatar.
The potential power of a being created with this template is significant. Central. Had we not intercepted it before the process was completed...
I know, Doctor. Continue your research. Let us know if you find anything else.
So that's obviously the culmination.
Now that we've managed to bring the alien's artifact back to the Shadow Chamber, we should start the analysis as soon as possible. It's risky, but I don't see any way we can avoid powering it up if we're going to understand how it works.
As always, guys, this is all super interesting, so give it a read if you want. Pause the video and read it if you haven't. Really, really interesting. Well written, too. Okay, so, new Shadow Project. Avatar Autopsy, Psionic Gate. All other Shadow Projects must be completed. Psy Gate. I thought we already did that. Oh, this is what we... Oh, yes, we did the Psy Gate and then we captured it. Yes, now we get to actually research it. Hopefully not too many missions are going to keep popping up between all these Shadow Project missions. Nice. Soul Fire on Dahl. Fortress. Stasis. Soul Steel. That's a very good one. We'll take that. Keep scanning. Come on, two more days. Get the Psy Gate.
I hate to do this, but you're the only one who can pull this off.
Rover!
You know, I'd go myself if I could.
The gateway is primed. Is the subject prepared?
Ready.
Subject.
I hardwired what was left of the Codex brain into Rover. It should be emitting the same signal the Codex used to pass through the gateway.
Excellent. Let us begin. We've already seen the Codex opening a similar rift in the field. I am sure your device will be fine.
Device.
There. We're set to record across all spectrums.
Remember, go in. Take some quick readings, then come right back through, okay?
Sure thing, Mom.
Whoa. Are you seeing this?
It appears our signal has been received. Increasing power.
Doesn't look like any place we've been before. Or any place on Earth, for that matter.
Perhaps this is the source. The aliens' seat of power, if you will. Secure beyond any physical limitations.
Only one way to find out.
Go on. We're counting on you.
Really well, brave Rover.
Process did work. There was an instant where the device was in between locations. However, once that occurred, the gateway called for a second signature, an organic signature. When we could not provide one, it generated a sort of feedback pulse.
Obviously.
If the Codex creates the door, this organic signature must surely be the key.
Well, we better make sure we have the right key before we try again. I would hate for this to occur to something organic.
Agreed. I'll report our findings to the commander immediately.
Fascinating.
We are now prepared to autopsy the body of the powerful being we recovered, Commander. I feel that we may be on the cusp of attaining a complete understanding of this avatar we have long sought.
Plus, guys, more interesting reading here. Give it a go. Pause if you'd like. And I think we get to do the final Shadow Project. Here we go, 8 days. We'll probably get one, maybe two more missions before this actually finishes. Hopefully none. We can finish this campaign up, put a nice bow on it.
This creature represents a near-perfect fusion of human and elder DNA. Though remarkable, it appears as if the creature were unfinished. Perhaps why we were able to ultimately defeat it. Still, this can lead me to only one logical conclusion.
We've
closely.
I believe we have found our avatar.
Whoa. Actually, you know what? If any other missions pop up, even if they're guerrilla missions or whatever, we'll just decline them. We don't have to do them. Not going to endanger the campaign at this point. Ooh, unless this is the one that finally gives us Adam back. Ah, supplies and intel. Nah, we can just ignore it. It's fine. Yeah, it doesn't matter. It just gives them a bit more extra progress on the Avatar project.
Toward completing this Avatar project. We must stop them at any cost.
Decreased amount of supplies, but we're getting over a... Oh, wow, decreased it by a lot. Oh, we lost a contact. Okay, fine, still doesn't matter. In the greater scheme of things. But that does show why you can't ignore them early on. I mean, who did we lose? Brazil. No. Oceania, where was it? Europe, Asia? Doesn't matter. Put a bow on this campaign. Just as Tian finishes leveling up his latest ability. Nice. That's a shield. Not really needed. All of these last three are not all that needed. That means we can chuck in our third string Psy Trooper. There you go. So Tian is going to be our most... Tian Kruger is going to be our most... experienced Star Trooper, and it'll be him that goes on the final mission.
It won't be easy, but I think it's the only option we have at this point.
Agreed. We must inform the commander immediately.
Go right ahead.
Commander? Central? The Shadow Chamber has completed its analysis of the Avatar's DNA. It has identified the genetic sequence necessary to travel through the psionic gate.
Perfect. We can finally shut this Avatar project down for good.
However, the gate requires more than a mere transmission of genetic data.
The sequence has to be part of a live subject. The key only works in lockstep with the signal.
We don't have time to find another one of those things, let alone capture it.
No. That part we can handle. We make our own.
You're serious?
Quite. Though the specimen before us is damaged beyond repair, it has provided us with its complete genetic blueprint. We already possess an unaltered Avatar template from the Forge facility. That, combined with the genetic material we recovered at the Black Site, should allow us to replicate the procedure here.
So, what's the catch?
Yes, that. Without an Elder consciousness driving it, the new Avatar would remain as lifeless as the one before us. While I can develop its body, I cannot create the mind to drive it.
But I can. In a way, by manipulating the new Avatar via the psionic network.
You want to operate one of these things by remote control?
Not exactly. And definitely not me.
Interfacing directly with their network would cause severe, if not fatal, trauma to an unprepared central nervous system. As it stands, we only know of one individual who has survived that kind of ordeal.
That was different. The stasis suit.
Created the perfect interface to the network. One tailored to your specific biology, Commander. Of any human candidate, you are the most likely to survive the connection.
Most likely is not good enough, Doctor.
It is the only answer I can give you. And our only option to traverse the alien portal.
We need to come up with a game plan before we charge through the enemy's front door. Which will give you some time to think about this, Commander.
I need to think. Let's do it. Strap me in.
This specimen, this being, is something else entirely. Something beyond anything we have ever seen. And yet somehow, our troops once again prevailed.
Now the last bit of interesting reading for you guys to do. Give it a pause and a read if you'd like to. Super interesting. No Shadow Projects available. I think it's time.
Hello,
go to the final mission. box, strong box. We're not going to stick around for that anyway.
Priority message for the commander coming through on a secure channel, sir.
On screen.
Sir, it's coming from the Advent Network Tower.
You heard me. He's taking a big risk contacting us like this.
Hello, Commander. You and your crew are to be commended. Your efforts in rebuilding the Resistance Network and uncovering the truth about the Avatar Project have been admirable. I only wish I had better news to report.
When does he ever?
Advent is not taking the death of an elder lightly, and in turn have greatly accelerated the final stages of their Avatar Project. A plan is now in place for the rapid processing of all non-essential human life. To begin immediately. Very soon, Advent's speaker will announce a breakthrough in gene therapy. A final treatment for the human condition. Billions will flock to gene therapy clinics across the globe. They will never return. I have managed to secure tactical data and access codes to the Advent Network Tower. The speaker's address will be broadcast live to a global audience via this facility. The whole of Advent's network will be listening. It is this hubris that we must use against them. The information I am sending you should allow Dr. Tigan and Chief Engineer Shen to take control of the transmission and disrupt their entire network from within. Though my hope is that this disruption will confuse the enemy's forces long enough to allow your final assault a chance of success, I ask one more thing of you. Take what you have learned. Let the world know what is happening here. Wake them up. Broadcast the truth before there is no one left to listen. It seems we are both out of time. Farewell, Commander.
Hectic. Serious bald dude. No! Salt the Advent Network Tower.
It looks like we've got our work cut out for us, Commander.
The Elders have always been elusive.
We have the target site locked in, Commander. This is our chance to strike at Advent's heart. Once we control the network tower, we can finally show the world what the aliens are doing. There's no turning back after this.
Oh, it's pretty much having the intel available. I mean, we could leave this just for as long as it takes to crack that data pad. Probably going to mean that we need to ignore another mission.
Proceeding as expected, Commander.
7 days, nah, it's too long. You know what, we're never going to need it. I'm confident we're going to take some kernels out to do this. Only 10 enemies anyway, for goodness sake. Codex, Archon, Elite Viper, Muton, Heavy Mech. So, mechanized, organic, and mechanized.
Commander, once we move on the Advent Network Tower, it's all or nothing. We won't have time to advance our research or deal with the wounded. We should only deploy once we're fully prepared.
You know what? Not yet. I think that's as good a time as any to call it a break for this episode. When we come back, it'll be our final assault. Well, that's the Network Tower, then it's the final assault. And we're going to put a cap on this campaign. Win or lose. Either way, it's going to be the end. We've been cruising through the late game. We've become so powerful with all these weapons and skills at our disposal that I think it's super important now that in these final two missions I don't get overconfident. It would be such a tragedy, really. It would be a pity to make it all the way through to the last mission and then fail there. Hopefully that won't happen. Alrighty, so catch you next time, guys, for the final assault. As always, I'm Stobbie for 9. Thanks very much for watching. I'll see you next time.